All right, what's up, guys? It is 11:08 a.m. right now. I just got back from school. All we really did was a graduation practice. It only took like 2 hours. And the whole point of today is I just want to have like a very, very, very big refeed, because when I woke up today, I couldn't film this because I didn't have any time, but I weighed 186 point something pounds. I was like 195, 193 like a few weeks ago. So just like due to like lots of stress and lots of work, I did lose a little bit of weight. But the whole point of today is I just want to refeed and eat a maximum amount of food. For breakfast, right, I had 2 scoops of whey. I had a had some BCAs and a muffin, right? But I didn't finish the muffin. I'm currently gonna go to Quinn's house right now. I'm gonna pick up my little Sony vlogging camera and I'm gonna eat the muffin there. And then we're gonna go home and we're gonna see what we gotta do for the rest of the day. All right, what's up, guys? I'm in Quinn's house right now. I'm in his dad's house that he just moved into not that long ago, and it's kind of weird. I've never actually been in this house, so I'm gonna give myself a personal tour. So I'm assuming we got the living room over here. Bunch of living room action. There's a door right here that goes to somewhere. I don't wanna know where that goes. Actually, I kinda do. It's a closet with a router. Everything's cool, everything's safe. No skeletons, no dead bodies, anything. I don't want to open that door. That looks sketchy. It looks like someone's bedroom. This little closet, just a bunch of stuff. This is the only room that I'm actually familiar with. This is Quinn's room. Quinn's in the kitchen right now. He doesn't know I'm in his room, snooping around. All right. He's got some protein, some vitamins, a TV, some clothes, camera bag. I mean, laptop bag. Gym bag and bed where he does all sleeping and stuff. That's Quinn's room. Quinn, stop sneezing. You have an upstairs? Yo, can I go upstairs?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go upstairs by myself. Oh no. Ooh, a little surfboard action. I feel like someone's gonna be up here. Whoa. Who is this? A nice little bed, nice little cabinet TV. Ooh, it's kind of like, oh shit. Quinn, there was someone upstairs sleeping. I don't know, it was like in the corner. Like I go up, I'm like, oh, it's a nice bed, it's a nice cabinet. Then I'm about to go to the other place and I literally see some bed sheets moving around. Who's that?
I don't know.
Anyway, to continue the tour, we got a very well lit kitchen. You know what I mean? Shoot, that's looking a lot more. This one's too, I want the ripe one. Get some ripe action. I'm really curious to find out who's upstairs. Quinn, who was that?
I don't know, there's no one's car here.
Did you go upstairs and look?
No.
What do you mean, no? You go upstairs, right, you take a right, and there's like straight down there with like the orange blankets. Who is that?
My dad, Jackie here. I think so.
Oh, you guys, oh, what's up, guys? Like, look at all this shit. There's a little girl sleeping here. Okay. What you doing, Quinn?
Just checking out some.
Quinn's checking out his analytics. That's cool. Alright, guys, so like I said, wow, dynamic range is not clean. The best dynamic range is the human eye, and then it's film cameras, then it's some top end digital cameras. Then we go 25 steps on and we have this little vlogging camera. Like I said, I had 2 scoops of whey for breakfast and a little BCAs, which I'm still sipping on. Strawberry Kiwi Extend. Real good. So now I'm gonna eat this 710, no, 700. Is it 710 or 720?
I think it was 710. I mean, if it's 710, 720, it's about the same thing. Don't worry about it.
We're gonna say 715. Oh. 715 calorie muffin, right? And what do you say, it's like a 60 calorie banana?
Yeah, 60, 70.
Yeah, well, 64.6. And guys, don't be fooled. I know BCA say on the bottle that, oh, it's zero calories. Well, the reason they say that is because they're legally able to say that because it's not a complete protein, so technically, like, it doesn't register as a calorie or whatever, but it has calories in it, don't be fooled. All right, let's eat this. All right, I don't know if you guys watch Game of Thrones or not, but in the very last episode, there was a very, very cool, like, it was kind of a funny scene where Cersei Lannister basically says, I want violence. And then a bunch of little boys, right, with a bunch of axes who think they run shit, right? They were like, you know what? get out of the way, Mountain. Mountain's like, I'm not going anywhere. And he just slams him around. So I think I'm going to show you guys that scene. Me and Quinn are going to give a little reaction to it. After I eat this muffin, priority number one, calories, gains, refeed, muscles, glycogen. Yeah. All right, guys, I'm done with my muffin. Stop dropping stuff. Sloppy. All right, anyway, I'm done my muffin. That was a breeze to eat. That was a joke. Now I just got my banana and finished this. And meanwhile, me and Quinn just want to give a little reaction and just show you guys a scene in Game of Thrones, which I thought was pretty cool. Fresh toast sticks from the refrigerator?
Yeah.
You didn't eat them cold?
No, they're warm.
From the refrigerator. That makes perfect sense. You don't have to explain yourself. Never mind. Let's keep on going. All right. What?
Okay.
What is this? You got a can of maple syrup. Did you get that out of microwave?
Yeah, it's natural maple syrup. 200 calories, a tablespoon. Oh, no.
Trying to get fat.
A fourth cup, never mind, not a tablespoon.
Yeah, bro, you're not gonna get fat.
Carbs.
You know what you just poured right there? You know, okay, I'm gonna explain to you guys what this is, what syrup is. I'm gonna be real with you if you guys wanna know the actual truth. This syrup, believe it or not, the symbolic meaning of this can right here is Instagram followers. Because when you eat this syrup, right, you're going to get full, you're going to get veiny, you're going to go to the gym, you're going to great pump, you're going to take a good picture, you're going to post on Instagram, put a few of the right hashtags, a few of the right people are going to see it, you're going to get followers. You can buy followers at ShopRite right here. But anyway, let's watch this scene of Game of Thrones. So this is a...
His Holiness the High Septon wishes...
What?
No, I thought you wanted to talk.
His Holiness the High Septon.
Basically, this is a big zombie, genetically modified moss right here. They're, like, arguing a little bit. Like, oh, like, these people coming right here. Like, oh, we want you to come and talk to this person. Like, you kind of have to do it. And she's like, absolutely not. I'm not leaving this place.
Are you sure you want to refuse?
If he wants to talk, he can come here. And she's like, I refuse.
You promised me I could stay in the Red Keep. Until my trial.
Made no such promises. If you refuse to come of your own free will.
Uh-oh. He doesn't like that. Those are the piss troopers right there. Oh no.
Besides, sir.
He doesn't like that.
Order your man to step aside and there will be violence.
He's out of his tree.
No.
Lost his mind. Damn right you do.
When do you think in this moment this guy realized he messed up?
Oh, he messed up bad.
Right now? This is when he realized. Yeah, he knows.
That guy's, that monster's been doing his lateral raises, his front delts. He can pick a boy up. Alright kids, if you're under the age of 17, please turn around right now. Oh no. Now listen to this, here's the best part.
Please tell His High Holiness he's always welcome to visit.
What'd you think about that?
Oh, that was one of my favorite scenes.
Yeah,
that's honestly, that's probably my favorite scene so far this season. I have to review the other seasons and see what I like.
This season of Game of Thrones is coming to a wrap, and if you guys don't have like HBO on your network, or if you don't even have TV in general, I'm pretty sure what you could do is there's a service or website called like HBO Go or HBO Now. You could sign up for a month for free, and since there's only 2 episodes left, if you sign up now, you'll be able to watch the whole entire season of Game of Thrones for free, basically. So even if you haven't seen the whole last season or any season at all, right now, put this video on pause, right? Sign up for HBO Go or HBO Now. Watch every episode of Game of Thrones that ever came out and continue watching this video. Because you can't move on with life unless you've seen Game of Thrones. It's just a fact. It's just how it is.
Mm-hmm.
Very true. And also for other TV shows, you guys have to watch Breaking Bad, obviously. Dexter. Lost is a classic. Just watch Lost. Get into that. What else? What else, like, good big TV shows?
I think Walking Dead.
Walking Dead, yeah. Like, the things with Walking Dead, I was watching it consistently since the very first season, but something happened recently. Like, I think, like, 2 seasons ago I stopped watching. I just, like, something just got really weird, and I lost my interest, so I stopped watching. But I hear it's getting good now. I hear it's getting real good. I gotta get back on that. Oh, another show, Arrow. I watched. Oh, Arrow was so good in the beginning, but like in one of the last seasons, something just got really corny and cheesy about it. Like, it looked like the whole like production staff and the camera staff and the director was like taken over by a bunch of like high school like media production students. Like, it doesn't have its like dark feel anymore. So I think I stopped watching like either the last season or the season before that. But summer's coming around. We got lots of free time, so I definitely got to get back on that. Flash wasn't really my thing. Here it's getting good. I'm gonna watch that too. There's just so many good shows out there. So, oh, Quinn, have you seen Daredevil?
Was it a movie?
What? Not the one with Ben Affleck. The TV show.
No.
Guys, you gotta watch Daredevil immediately. It's like one of the biggest hit shows right now. So definitely watch Daredevil. All right, guys. So that's a wrap for breakfast. I stopped by. I got my camera. Said hi to Quinn. Quinn's currently going to start editing this vlog, which should be out definitely before this vlog's out, so check it out on his channel. And I'll probably be seeing Quinn at the gym later today, right? Like, you're going to be there like 5 and stuff, around there. Quinn might hit arms today. That's the moral of the story. So yeah, I'm going to go home now and see what we got next. All right, guys, I just got home and I got a little surprise. Another package in the mail. That was unexpected. All right, so once again, I got to do this sketchy one-hand unboxing. I'm just gonna open it up and I'm gonna play it again. All right, guys, the box is opened up, so we're gonna open it together at the same time. One flap, two flap. Let's see, move this away. So there's a, oh, I think this is the YouTube plaque. Whoa, that is clean. Got a nice letter from YouTube here. So it comes in this nice box, and let's open this up. Wow. That is clean. Damn, that's crazy. Like, the whole plaque just in general is like so much more high quality. Like, it's like nice metal edges, glass. So 100,000 subscribers. I'd like to thank you guys for helping me reach this point. So obviously, if it wasn't for you, I would not be here. I would not be able to make any of these videos. I would not be able to do anything. So I highly, highly appreciate that. And just wow, that's crazy. I'm at about 150K right now. So it just came in the mail in this nice little box. BRB, gotta make an Insta post. Alright, guys, next meal is this plate of ravioli that I made yesterday, and then I got super tired and I just passed that and I didn't eat it. So I'm gonna finish this now. I'm going to delete this meal with this glass of water. Real motivated to finish this. One of my favorite, actually hands down my favorite YouTube movie reviewer, Jeremy Jams. Check him out. This weekend I went to go see Now You See Me Too. It was actually very, very good. It's like one of those heist movies where a bunch of little subtle things happen during the movie that are made to be technically seen, but you're not supposed to pick up on it. And at the end, they're supposed to have a big grand reveal. They'll reveal all the little things that happen that leads up to this moment and stuff. So I obviously knew it's gonna be one of those kinds of movies. So I was sitting there, I was thinking of every single possible outcome. Okay, no, it's this guy. Like, this guy has, no, it can't be simple, it can't be him, it was this, this, and this. But I got one thing right, one of the big key things right, and I'm actually very happy that I was able to get that. But the rest of the movie, it tricked me, it got me, it was really good. So if you guys want to go see Now You See Me Too, highly recommend. So I was playing around with the drone yesterday, right? I took it to the church where me and Quinn took it for his video, and I basically flew it above the church and I put the drone on point of interest mode, basically where it circles a given thing that I tell it to circle, and I don't have to touch the remote at all, just on autopilot, just circling and circling at a set altitude and a set diameter at a set speed also, which is really cool. So I just wanted to test that out, and here's some color grading to the footage. This is a completely raw, and pretty much what I did right here is I added some letterbox action. I made the highlights a little warmer, made the midtones kind of blue, and I think I left the shadows alone, so just, and I obviously increased the contrast as well, and I played with some of the midtone shadows and highlights of the exposure just to give it a nicer look. And it's kind of crazy because without it, it just looks just kind of like iPhone footage, but with it, it just looks so much more professional. So I'm gonna play a clip of it just circling around the church, and I did speed it up a little bit, but that's basically how it flies on autopilot. So here you go. Alright, so for Quinn's football video, since we're going to use the drone, I really want to have like a nice intro, so I'm going to start out with the drone decently high up, and it's going to be circling around the football field, right? It's going to do two rotations that we're going to speed up, of course, and then it's going to go into the drone hovering above the field, like pretty decently low, like maybe like 10 meters up, and just zooming across the field and just like stopping in front of Quinn, and everyone else is going to show up and play football, and that's going to be his intro. And hopefully we'll have enough battery to film as much gameplay as we possibly can from up high, and the rest is going to be filmed on just the DSLR on this camera. So hopefully everything's going to go well. Hopefully I don't crash it again. So today's Thursday, right? We should be filming that video on Saturday, so it'll probably be up Sunday or Monday if everything goes up well. Hopefully you guys will see that video. I'm excited for it. I can't wait to film it. Alright guys, it's time to take creatine. You know how it is. One scoop. Quick, easy, and simple. If you have any creatine questions, you could just leave them down. Don't even ask them. Just take it. 5 grams a day. You know how it works. Just take it. All right, what's up, guys? I'm currently babysitting my one-year-old baby brother while my mom trains right now. She's doing her 5x5s. And he's trying to figure out how to play Geometry Dash on my phone. We got my phone now. Let me see what you're playing. What are you doing? What are you, camera shy now? You don't want to start eating my phone, ripping it apart? What's up? Ooh, speaking of Geometry Dash, right? I filmed this one clip of me, Dylan, Quinn in the car. It was probably like 3 weeks ago, so I'm going to play that now. You got to go really micro tap.
No, but to get it going right here, you can't.
Yeah, but you can't hold it for too long. You're going to hit that thing.
Oh!
You guys, you have to weave through it like that there. You can forget about it.
That's a fucking load of bullshit. That's a crock of horseshit.
Shit! Dude, you
fuck! It literally doesn't work sometimes.
Dude, you guys, so
it's, it's glitching, that's
ooh,
why.
Ooh, you made a checkpoint.
That's good why, it's because I'm glitching. That's the only reason it's why it's not why I'm dying. That was a glitch. It literally glitched.
You want me to show you how to do it?
No, it's a glitch. You can't do
it. It's just not glitching, dude.
It just glitched up.
Dude, you just fucking suck.
No, it's literally just glitching out. Like, if it wasn't, I would literally...
Oh, my God!
Oh! I wasn't shit. Thinking of it. That's what happened, because I wasn't thinking about it.
Dude, if you literally, if you get through here, I'm like, I'll actually be really impressed. Swoop, tap, 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 down, swoop, tap, tap, tap.
Oh, whoa. Wait, if I get to this part, you'll be impressed?
You have to get past the flying shit.
Ooh, I could have gotten it. I know I can now. I know I can do it. When it gets right there, it gets really fucking hard.
Oh.
Whoa.
Oh, shit. Yeah, it's upside down action
now.
Wow, tap, 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 portal, normal side, don't.
Let it go, yeah.
Oh. Dude, you can't brute force tap, you gotta literally time it right.
This is all about memorization.
Oh, shit! Dude, you're gonna bounce on this thing, right? There's this thing there, you have to avoid it. Get it? Oh my God.
I didn't tap in time.
Tap. Ooh.
Tap.
Oh! Oh! Now you gotta jump over that and hit the second blue one.
What the fuck?
Oh, you gotta hit that. Oh, just a little too late. What the fuck?
You got it.
Ah, oh, yes.
Oh, oh my
just
shit.
Let it fall. Oh, let it fall. Oh, go. Okay. Oh,
you pretty much, this will be easy.
It's not as easy as you say.
Yeah. You're done.
It's easy as fuck.
Yo, can I try? Can I try really quick?
You don't. Ew. Can't beat that shit.
Yo, I'm not going to the gym. We're going home.
Yo, watch.
That's so unimpressive, because it's just so impressive that, like, it's unimpressive.
There's no build-up, it's just decimation.
He's decimating it. Quinn, you can't do that on the first try.
No shot, I can't.
I'll tell you when you're gonna die. Right up here.
Yeah?
Yup, wait for it. Wait for it.
He'll be waiting for it for the rest of the game.
That's absolutely horse shit. This is horse shit. This is absolute horse shit. No way. That's horse shit. I know for a fact he's not, you can't beat it. That's absolute horse dog shit.
Yeah, it's no big deal.
That's pissing
out, shit. This is easy, you gotta tap the right spot.
Yeah.
What? Don't tell me you know what that button is. Don't tell me you know what that button is. Get out. If you click play right now, I'll buy you the Apex 300 diapers, if you know what that is. Come on, kill it. Kill it. My orangutan action is gonna bring you back. My current geometry dash accomplishments. I started playing this game in school in one of my classes that I got really bored in, and I kind of got addicted to it and have been playing it every single day in school. But now school's over, so unfortunately, I'm probably never gonna play this game again. Looks like Quinn stole one of my pterodactyls. I gotta get that back. Limited edition bumper plates for the gym. Those orange ones just were a little bit too loud. These are gonna take hold and set. That's 45 pounds each, by the way. I could already feel myself getting a little fuller. We're only about like 2,000 calories and maybe a tad bit over. And I could already feel like my arms, like my delts and my back, just kind of like, I don't know, like just tighter in my shirt, just like filling up, just like, just feels tighter. So fullness is slowly starting to kick in. See how many more calories we can get. What is your name?
Lucas. Thomas.
Now, who are you?
We're David's brothers.
You two are my little brothers. This is correct. Now, which one of you wants to see magic trick?
Me.
All right, Thomas, what I'm gonna basically do is I'm gonna riffle through the side of the pack. You just say stop whenever.
Stop.
There, mm-hmm. Okay. This is your card. See the three hearts, you got it? All right, I'll take the three. Good camera work, Lucas.
That's weird.
And I'll put it in the middle. Here, just Lucas, show the cards. They wanna see the cards. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna snap my fingers and your card's gonna come to the top. Wait, it didn't, that's a mistake. But here, check this out. See this king, right? Do you notice what the king's holding in his hands? What is he holding? He's got two knives, right? Mm-hmm. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna take one of the knives, right? And I'm just gonna pull them off. So I got the knife in my hand. Now ready?
What Watch. The, where did it
Wait.
Go?
Three, two. Now I'm gonna go through the cards, right? I threw the knife at one specific part of the deck. Now let's see. I'm gonna keep going until we get, now here, look, show the deck. Until, let's see where that knife is. See if it's in between one of these cards. I hope it's not in between. I hope it actually, there's actually a knife stabbing the back of one of the cards. And that card is your three of hearts. What do you think about that, Thomas?
What the huckamoly?
Alright guys, as you see, I have a classic European wallet right here. And in this envelope is exactly one card. I made a prediction, right? You guys will see that in a second. I'm going to leave that envelope right there, and I'm just going to close it, and I'm going to keep it right here. Now, here's a normal pack of cards. Everything's normal. So, Thomas, I want you to take this deck, just shuffle it however you want. And after you think it's shuffled well, give it to Lucas. Oh, that's a sloppy big mess.
I know, I like shuffling like that. I just put it everywhere and then I make it back together.
Slobster. Here, give it to Lucas. Let him shuffle it.
No, some shuffle it.
Thomas, it's okay. Fine. Oh, God. All right, let's see what you got. Shuffle them up.
Okay, the wrong way.
When your hands get bigger, guys, I'm going to teach you a couple things. Can't be shuffling cards like that. Jesus. Slop City. All right, so set them down. Here's what I want you to do. Off the top of the deck, I want you to start going card by card. You can go a few cards at a time. Just go like this and just stop whenever you want. So here, Thomas, okay, so let's see. Lucas, just do it a few times. Put a few cards down. Start going by one. That's too big. There's no room for Thomas. Here, Thomas, you go. You go a couple. All right. Now, Thomas, just go card by card, one by one, and you could literally stop wherever you want. And this is the first time I'm using the word literally correctly. You could stop literally anywhere you want.
How about right here?
Okay. Now, you stop right here. Now, Lucas, do you want a card more? Do you want a card less? Do you want this card, this card, this card? Like, what do you want? You just touch anything you want at all. You want that one? Are you 100% sure?
Yes.
So you guys are happy. This is the card that you want. You don't want to change it to any other card in the deck.
No.
Okay, here, watch out. Come here. Lucas, here's what I want you to do. Don't leave that pile. Hold here, grab the camera.
I'm not supposed to be filming.
Just grab the camera. Just hold it just like that. Show it just that pile, right? So, in this envelope, right, I've made one prediction. Square this off here. Again, the envelope could be fully investigated. There's nothing here. There's nothing here. So let's square this off. So in this envelope, hold on. In this envelope, there's one card, one prediction. You show that it's empty. And I predicted that you would pick this card. Now let's go back here. Out of all the cards, you chose this one. You could have done here, like you could have done this one. You could have done this one. You could have picked any card, but you decided to pick this one. So I predicted that you picked the Queen of Diamonds, and you have in fact picked the Queen of Diamonds.
The red Queen of Diamonds.
Out of all these possible cards. Part-time bodybuilder, part-time powerlifter, part-time magician, part-time drone crasher, and part-time babysitter. What's up? What are you eating? What is this? Sloppy. There's not even any fiber in here. You got no excuse to be eating this. Ugh. What are you gonna eat now, huh?
I'm playing Hungry Fish. Я играю голодная рыба.
Кто тебе научил, как эту игру играть?
Я Томик.
Томик, почему вы каждый день, весь день просто постоянно играете над своими планшетками?
Нет.
Значит, Томас, это твоя планшетка?
Да.
Лукас, это твоя?
Да.
Что ты кушаешь? What are you eating? What is this? Tom, Sloppy! Мой маленький ребенок просто совсем свой мозг потерял. Куда он бежит? Ну-ка иди сюда, барабан. Маленький пупсик. Я понимаю, почему ты подсюда пошел. Ты просто хочешь прийти. Все спокойно, все хорошо. Ты просто будешь маленькие вещи кушать. Ты думаешь, что я маленький глупый мальчик, как ты? Нет. Я за тебя слежу. Я все вижу, что ты делаешь. все вижу. Мой самый маленький братик, которому один год, он просто постоянно любит ползти по земле. Любую штучку, которую он найдет, какашка, маленькая деревяшка, любую вещь, он просто берет и любит в рот брать. Ему вообще больше игрушки не нравятся. Забудь про игрушки, ему нравятся наушники, провода, компьютеры, телефоны, камеры. Так смешно, потому что ребенкам нравится, и они хотят, что им нельзя брать, в принципе, как. Если им что-то нельзя, они это захотят. Это прямо как взрослые тоже работают. Я просто думаю, что это очень круто. И он свою машину сейчас кушает под столе. Alright, back to English now. So, I'm just currently babysitting. Let's see what time it is. Where's my phone at? Hope the baby's not eating my... Okay, there it is. It is 2:45. My mom's workout should probably be around like 30 minutes. Then I'm done babysitting. Hopefully, I'll sneak in one quick meal, probably a liquid meal. Then I gotta go to the gym. I'm not really training today. I'm just basically bringing my DSLR. Steve's bringing an SD card. We're popping that SD card on my DSLR and I'm filming. Like, I'm gonna be a dedicated cameraman. I'm basically gonna film a shoulder workout for his channel. He's got to keep up some consistent content. Lucas, I know you want some Gymshark stuff. I know you're upset about it. I'll get you a t-shirt once your frame grows up. It's cool.
This is why I say shut up to you.
That's cute. All right, guys. I'll see you in a second. Simeon Panda has the longest arms I've ever seen on an individual. The fact that they're so big while being so long, like he does have more muscle mass in his arm than Phil Heath. It's crazy. Don't you want some Gymshark action? No. Yeah. Squat. Alright guys, I just finished babysitting. That took a lot longer than I thought, so I might be able to sneak in one more meal before I go to the gym to film Steven. But yeah, so super quick, I just want to show you guys. It's just a fraction of my card collection. Here's some of my favorite cards. These are actually the original Cincinnati, Ohio printed Tally-Ho circle backs. I like the circle backs way more than the fan backs. Come in blue and red. And these cards are really cheap. You can pretty much find them anywhere, but for some reason I really like them. I really like the finish that they have. And just some other fiddle decks. But one of my favorite ones, I actually got this on eBay the other day. These are limited edition. They don't make anymore. They don't make them anymore. This is the Dan Dave Smoke and Mirrors V3, I think. V3 or V4 green. These are real clean. Some nostalgia with these cards. Alright guys, it's 4:15 p.m. I didn't eat as much as I'd like to up to this point, but before I go to the gym, I'm basically gonna eat this bagel right here. It's got some tomatoes, cream cheese, and cucumbers on it. So that's gonna be my quick little meal. Then I'm gonna stop by 7-Eleven, probably get a few drinks, and then, yeah, go to the gym. Alright, I finished that bagel, so now I'm just gonna eat a yogurt and a cup of coffee, and then we're out. Alright guys, just finished the bagel, the yogurt, and the coffee. So right now I'm gonna go to the gym to film Steve, but I get a text from Dill. Dill was supposed to be off the gym today, but he decided why not, he's just gonna go, he's probably just gonna hit some arms, something light, whatever. So let's go get Dill, step one. What do you got on?
Got some Lunar Shark action.
Damn. You got a lot of comments. Some people loving the Hodge Twins impersonation, some not loving them so much. What do you got to say to those people?
I'm just fucking around. Like, I'm not actually, like, trying to be the Hodge Twins, obviously. I'm just, like, I think they're really funny. So I'm just trying to, like, do impersonations. Like, I'm not trying to, like, they already had it copyrighted. I am giving them proper copyrights. I'm just...
I don't think they get a royalty on it.
No, they have royalty. It is royalty.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Huh.
They have royalty. Dave, are you saying they don't have royalty?
Are they getting paid every time you say it?
Look at all this seamless action.
One of my favorites. I stopped by 7-Eleven, got some Poland Springs. I'm gonna sip that through the workout. I'm a little dehydrated. And a 320 calorie poopy purple drink. I'm gonna probably drink that like a little later on.
I got my light yogurt because I'm not like Quinn and I don't quit my cut. Yo, by the way, Quinn actually didn't really quit his cut. Like in like your last video, people Like, I think he said that joking, and I got over 30 DMs, 30 comments on my pictures. Four people got my number and called me. Some few people knocked on my door. A few people threatened my mom's life to know the answer if Quinn was, like, cutting or not. And he is still cutting. He just, like, is refeeding for a few days because he got too lean too quick.
No, he's bulking.
Oh, he is?
See you guys later.
Is he bulking?
On a bunch of food and just be happy and satisfied. Come on, Quinn. You're already lean enough. And think about it, Quinn, now, since you're already lean, in this first week of you binging, like an obese person, right, in that first week, you're not really going to gain the fat back. You're just going to be dripping full glycogen everywhere. You're going to wake up from your bed. You're going to be sheets are going to be soaked in glycogen.
Dude, it's so easy to fucking convince Quinn of something. Have you noticed that?
Yeah.
Quinn's like a child. Like, if I'm like, oh, Quinn, like, fucking take these two pre-workouts together that don't fucking mix at all, you probably shouldn't take. Fuck it, I want to see what happens. Oh, yeah, I take it, all right. Fucking brick titty.
You know what happens if he eats it, right? That means he's bulking.
He's been going to Wendy's every night after we train. I mean, I'm cutting.
Oh, he's a subconscious seep through. He knows he wants to bulk.
Absolutely not. I'm gonna bulk next winter.
It's all right, dude. You can be the small guy in the group now. We're gonna put our clothes
I'm
on.
Be the small guy.
We're gonna go out. You're gonna be all. You're
gonna
be all lean.
A small little guy, smaller than all of you.
Dill's cut's gonna be compromised.
You know, it's actually really funny. Quinn's like, he does like. He's actually like, he told me specifically in person that like he's cutting because he told me, oh, I'm doing this for like 5 days, I'm still cutting because he doesn't want me to bulk because he knows I'll be bigger and stronger than him. But it's all right, guys, I'm still cutting. So Quinn is time. All
right, guys, we pulled up to Island. We're waiting for Steve to come, and I'm gonna film his workout on this DSLR, and I figured now that we have the time, oh snap, I'm gonna show you guys what's in this bag. This is a low pro bag. Open this up.
Are you gonna show me 1835 millimeter?
Yeah, I'm gonna show him everything.
1.8 lens.
You can put your laptop in here. You can put a bunch of stuff in here, whatever you want. Now, for the grand sexiness of this bag, we go in here. Let's start with the boring stuff. Here we have a microfiber cloth and some stuff that you basically put on the lens, then you clean it with a microfiber cloth and some lens cleaner, action fluid, yeah. And here we have some Q-tips, and these are actually lens cleaner wipes. These are really good. I use this for pretty much like all technology that gets dirty, like MacBook screen, lens, whatever. It's all good. Here, I have a neutral density filter for my stock kit lens, which I don't use. And here is a bunch of 9-volt batteries for the Rode VideoMic Pro, which is over here. Really good mic.
Everyone's
shotgun
got
mic.
That mic. If you have a YouTube, you have that mic.
Yeah.
You better have that mic.
Alright, so the main camera right here, the Canon 70D. What kind of lens is this still?
This is a 1835mm 1.8. Wait, what is it? Yeah, 1.8.
You're saying a bunch of numbers, you're like
1835mm 1.35mm 1.18 sigma.
It's like you can't speak English and you're trying to like say it, but you fully understand
okay,
it in a different language.
It's 1835 millimeter.
Okay,
yeah,
now let me say, this is a Sigma 18-235 millimeter f1.8 Sigma art lens.
What do you mean it says 1835 millimeter?
It's not 1835.
18 to 35.
It's not 1,835. It's 18-235.
Yeah, it's
18-235. Yeah, 35. You got to 18, yeah, 2. So yeah. Great lens. This lens actually ended up costing more than the camera itself, but it's definitely worth it. The best part about it, it's a fixed aperture of 1.8, so no matter how much you zoom, it's going to stay at 1.8, so it's not going to change your exposure settings, because pretty much every other zoom lens closes up the aperture when you zoom in more, which sucks. So, little lens flare hood. Sometimes I put this on to make it seem more official and scary. This is, look at this little bitch lens. This is the stock lens.
Is that
this
the one that Justin has?
I don't know. This is an 18 to 55 millimeter. I think it's a 3.5 to 5.6.
Is that Thrill or something?
It's literally, I mean, if you want to drink coffee out of it, like, you can go ahead. It's a sloppy lens.
No, it's not. Look, when I look through it, it looks clean.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. This is a This is a great lens. If you're like on a budget and stuff, and you have a crop sensor camera, definitely get this. This is a 50mm 1.8 prime. Oh no! Big Steven!
Why are you masked here, dude?
I don't know, Steve. Someone's trying to bust in my car. Alright, I'm wrapping up this camera bag. So yeah, get this lens. Here's the camera strap. Extra battery. Steve's here.
Oh, snap.
Why?
I don't know.
Dude, right now, dude, I'm finally feeling the cut, dude.
True.
I was like 178, 179, no shoes on. I just feel like flatter, just kind of tired.
But then once you carb up, you feel good.
Yeah. Dude, do you carb up yet? Huh? I haven't really needed to because it's like
I pre-workout carb.
I'm gonna tomorrow or the next day. I'm probably gonna like eat whatever the fuck I want to eat. Steve, to the right, you see my cap and gown. Steve, I'm graduating tomorrow. I'm at the end of the real world,
you
just like
you, graduation?
Huh?
You come to our graduation?
Do you want to come for 4 hours or graduation? Sit down
no
and watch.
Way, dude.
Wow, Steve, you're so unsupportive.
It's gonna rain tomorrow, I think.
Yeah, but not during graduation. In the morning it is.
Man.
You just looked at the basic weather things.
I remember
things,
from my graduation, it was like pouring rain, dude. They didn't even call my name.
You just said, what do you mean they didn't call your name? Where'd Dave go? He ran away.
Yeah, then you went inside.
Damn.
Went for Sean.
Dude, something about Dave's shoulders hasn't been looking the same.
Looking what?
It hasn't been looking the same. Like
what?
In the past like few weeks.
What happened? Damn, it's a nice ass camera.
I don't know.
Are you gonna get that? Steve, let me show you this camera. I'm gonna give you a tour. Here's going to rock bottom while we wait for Sean. Perfect. I'm over here,
what?
Sean.
What'd you just say, Sean?
Did you already get a pump before you walked in here?
No, not yet.
Damn.
So if you don't tie your laces, it gives you a pump.
Damn.
My lower back kind of hurts.
Why?
You can't compete now in the show. I'll take your spot. I don't like
you can't
it. Probably there. Long. I'm telling you, it's because his arms are too long.
Nah, you would have worn him if I was in there.
But it's an NPC, like fucking anyone.
About to go get this shoulder workout in.
Damn.
Steve hit me up to push him for these final days, so.
Uh-oh. But you doing a show like same time as him, roughly?
Nah, I just finished the show last week, but did men's physique. It wasn't really, I had fun, but you know, I'm ready to grow and get on the stage for Classic, so.
Damn, wait, did you win that show?
That's with clothes and shoes on. This morning I was at 170.
Alright, let me tell you, Steve weighs 175 on the scale. He looks 165 in the shirt, but when it comes off, it'd be 210. That's how it works. Alright guys, I'll be right back. I gotta film some of Steve's workout.
Show people side by side, this is what pictures actually can do.
I was thinking about doing something like that.
You're gonna...
Gotta stay pumped.
Did you see this picture I sent you of Dill?
What?
I'll wait till you're done.
Dude. Yo, Quinn, we're gonna clear this up right now. Are you? Because I don't want another question.
I already answered it in my video, dude. It has to come up. But since people, it was on Dave's channel when I announced it. I am still cutting. I'm just doing a little refeed to kind of like, I'm taking my time. I want to be comfortable with my cut. So, like, it's pretty harsh, yeah, bro.
It's funny. Me and Dill were watching actually. I was filming Dill. Watch my video, like when you're in the kitchen, you eat that like bagel thing, and like
I fucked him up. I fucked you up. You'll have to see it, Quinn. But what's it called? What was I gonna say? And was the reason why you're doing it, Quinn, right? Is because you lost too much weight kind of too quick.
Yeah,
and then like you literally, like you just kind of lost a lot of strength. Now you like got, you wanted to get your fullness back and then restart with a little bit higher calories.
Yeah, I don't, yeah, I want to be more comfortable with my cut and go at a slower pace. I was losing weight a little too fast, and
yeah, you were.
It was starting to get like really excessive, and I'm not like prepping for a competition or anything, so there's no point in me really leaning out that fast,
getting like shredded really quick.
I want to take my time with it.
But next week in an upcoming vlog, me and Bill are gonna do a big Sam's Club trip.
I'm gonna have to push the car because Dave's down with muscle mass this week.
We gotta get some mayonnaise. I gotta get some white hoagie rolls.
Some hoagie rolls, eh?
We all have to eat a Carolina Reaper pepper. Do you know what like Tabasco is? You know what Tabasco hot sauce is? Okay, do you know what a jalapeno pepper is?
These all ring.
You know how they're very hot jalapeno peppers? And the actual pepper, right? It, like, not like when you get a little slice, a little poopy.
Is it dangerous? No, listen. No tolerance going into that?
We'll get to that, but listen. This is what I'm saying, right? Okay, so there's something called a Scoville unit, right? This, a jalapeno is like 3,000 to 5,000 on a Scoville. I could be wrong, could be like a little more. A Carolina Reaper is roughly 2.5 million.
I'll pay.
You can literally, like, it burns your throat. You literally are in, I've seen videos, people are in fucking absolute.
All right, hear this out.
Agony.
Deal.
Can't do anything about it. You literally want to commit suicide on the spot.
You gotta have some heroin on hand.
It's 2,200,000.
Yup. Yeah. I'll give you and Quinn $100 to do it on my channel.
Really?
Yeah, honestly.
I might throw up, dude.
No, you absolutely will throw up.
One of Christian Guzman's like the thumbnail of his new vlog. I don't think I didn't watch it like yet, the whole thing. And literally they sent him like this many monsters. Like no individual was like at his house just sitting this many monsters. And he was like, this can't be healthy, I think the title.
But you think about how many grams of caffeine that is.
How much money would I pay you for you to drink a whole case of that?
Drink a whole case?
Yeah.
I would probably
within
die.
Within like a day. We'll do that.
How much money?
Yeah.
You know, we can make a monster challenge.
We're gonna have a bunch of challenges.
No, $7.50.
$7.50? I'd do it for $5.
$7.50? You guys are out of your tree.
180 grams of caffeine. So that's a lot of grams of caffeine. Like, you could overdose. You will.
You can't. You actually can't overdose on caffeine? Like that. The LD50 for caffeine is ridiculous. And if you're getting in liquid like that in combination with, you just won't.
Well, in 24 hours, if you hit, no, you can overdose on caffeine.
No, you can't.
If you took a whole bottle of caffeine pills, you could.
Oh, like that? Yeah, you could. But I'm saying through these monster drinks, you can't.
Why?
Like, no matter what.
Why? Is it because
the release? LD50 is so high for it.
What,
so if
the
you're,
release of this?
It's not about the release. It's the fact that, okay, you're drinking a whole bottle, right? Let's say it has like 100 milligrams of caffeine. There's still this much volume of like liquid in your stomach, and only a small like micro fraction of it is caffeine. So you drinking all this, yeah, it would be super amped up, but you're not going to
so
die.
It would dissipate some of the caffeine.
So you would need to literally take like.
So if I was Matt Stoney and I fucking
ate the whole
thing. So you need to literally take multiple. Yeah, it's so cheap.
Yeah, you should get a different. I don't know.
You want some? I can give you one or two. Do you need them? I'll give you one.
I have one.
All right. So we got the 710 calorie muffins, right? Now we need some hoagie rolls for my sandwiches.
Look at him bubble up. Look at him. He's gonna do it. Look at him. He's gonna do it. Oh, he didn't do it because I said. Oh, look at him.
Oh, Quinn. Oh, you still cutting? Oh, look at his willpower. So impressive.
Dude, I'm so impressed how Quinn looks that big with a Revo pump right now. That's so impressive.
Quinn, dude, put the calories down. This is your chicken and boiled broccoli,
no,
right?
No, I'm not cutting
it. You're a bodybuilder. You can put that away. Quinn, how fat do you want to get? The one with the lowest insta followers got to push the cart.
I guess today, that's me. I think when I make my channel, like, every video is going to have a different wig. I'm going to, like, talk in a different language.
In a different language.
Yeah. Wait, what are they?
Targaryens. Yeah.
I'm like, oh, Shmish Kadash.
No, I think
is
that's...
Is he a savage? No. What's his name?
No, those are... Oh, Quinn. What's the name of that gang? Not the gang, but, like, where Khal Drogo's from? When they get some potato chips.
Oh, shit. Oh, another one. Oh, what's her name? Khaleesi?
Yeah,
Khaleesi. Fucking heart.
Yeah. Oh, that's but Quinn. What are they?
Hold on. I'll remember in a couple seconds.
Wait, hold on. Wait. Who Drogo? Like, what?
Yeah, the Khal Drogo. What's their gang?
It's,
Dothraki? Yeah.
Dothraki.
There you go.
Dothraki.
There you go. That makes sense.
Bambino. He literally... Dude, I feel like he's literally by himself walking. He's like, yeah, look at Bambino. Like, literally, just, something's wrong. Dude, yeah, literally, I was trying to play the look back. Steve was literally like, he was like, yeah. Like, he was like this. He was like... Like, I was like, what the fuck? I thought it was wrong.
No.
Nice thick salami.
Absolutely not. We're gonna get some provolone cheese.
These are like really good looking clean mashed potatoes, and it's like 180 calories per half a cup. That's literally 3 spoonfuls.
This is mashed potatoes?
Yeah, like it's just like buttered mashed potatoes. Like with salt and cracker.
I'll test it out. Why not?
It's got mad syrup.
I'll do it.
No, it's salami. Yeah. Salami, right?
So how many languages can you speak again?
Now that I think about it, one.
Nah,
actually,
yeah.
I can speak French.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Asperger.
Je m'appelle Asperger.
Yeah.
Like, I remember when he first started, now he's popping. So he was cold and
Yo, we gotta get Steve to bless someone in the middle of the gym. Steve, CAO. I don't know how to say his last name. Cow.
It's a cow, chow, wow.
It's cow.
It's cow.
It's cow, chow, wow.
Yeah, I just say, I'm like, yo, my friend Steve, CAO. But yeah, literally, yeah, honestly, we should get Steve Gagnon to come in. Dude, have you ever seen him bless somebody?
Yes.
Oh my god, dude, we literally, I remember how, dude, it's crazy. He's like,
what are you filming me for, man?
So, we got a bunch of fat foods, and now we're gonna get micronutrients. So, box of blueberries, can never go wrong with that. And we're gonna get some raspberries. Oh, that one looks sketchy. Alright, this one's fine. Oh, these are sloppy and old, ew. What is this? Oh no. I'm gonna get these instead. Stuff back. Ooh, that's clean.
Can you get me one of these?
Oh, it's when your shoelaces are stuck. Like,
no.
That's why you can't come get in my car on time when it's time to go to the gym.
I need one of these. Can you get me one?
How much is it?
It's $80. I'm kidding.
Oh, Quinny's kidding. We had no clues. Oh, shit. You're kidding. All right.
I know, literally, Quinn's going to wait.
Oh, Quinn, that's the Apple iPhone 6S Plus. You know that company Apple?
Yeah. Yes.
I feel like I can get some. I feel like I'm missing something.
If you got TV, I want one from
you. I'm definitely missing something. I don't know what it is.
I like big things, big guys.
You like big things? You like big guys, yeah. And big things?
I want to touch Big Randy and try to kill him.
I'm gonna do a little experiment, right, to self-checkouts of 10 items or less, and I have 11 items, so I'm curious if, like, it'll, like, let me stop scanning after, like,
10. Dave! It says 10 or less. Why would it say, it would say 11 or less, right? Would it, Quinn?
I don't know. Quinn, what do you think?
Well, I think there's some leeway.
there's like, definitely some leeway.
Yeah, it's not gonna be.
So I don't care what you think, to be honest.
Get off the shit.
Yeah, I don't like that.
It's pants. Looking clean.
Let me get this good.
All the fresh, clean drones Dave's gonna use when he breaks his next one. So now what are we doing?
McDonald's.
Oh, yes! McDonald's.
Wait, only good for one thing. Thing my legs are efficient in is a low bar squat.
You're acting like it's the end of the world.
The world could end.
Double quarter, that's exactly what he wants.
Wait, hold. Oh, Quinn, you want a Big Mac too, right?
Double.
Can I get 10-piece chicken McNuggets?
Make two.
Barbecue.
Another 10-10.
And another 10-piece chicken McNuggets with more barbecue.
Anything else?
Two Big Macs.
Anything else?
And a two double quarter pounder with bacon and two sweet teas.
And a double quarter pounder with bacon and two cookies.
Sweet teas.
Double quarter pounder with bacon and...
Two sweet teas.
Yeah, that's the place, Quinn. Ichiban.
That'd be it. Thank you.
Okay, so I have two large sweet teas for 2 10-nuggets, 2 Big Macs.
I kind of want the cookies now.
Quinn, you 100% said two cookies.
Did he?
I said two sweet teas. I heard two cookies,
and then I was like confused. Well, I heard
sweet tea.
You were like laughing when I said, so I thought you knew that.
No, I was.
Oh, this is heavy. Oh my.
Dude, you guys can like eat in my backyard if you want. Want
to do that?
Yeah.
I really
want to drive over them. Want me to drive over?
Yeah, definitely.
Let's see if I can drive and vlog at the same time. So we're gonna go eat at Dylan's house because that seems to be the place to go for food, unboxing, you name it, Dylan's place. For some strange reason, I guess because it's local and convenient. Yeah. The Gymshark action. Ooh. I always thought it was like really cool. I never understood it. I stalled this car out a bunch of times, grind some gears, fucking smoke came out of my car, you name it. But eventually learned it. Actually, the experience of me learning how to drive stick was I got the car and I had work that same day. My only mode of transportation was to drive this car there. So I had to learn stick in 45 minutes and get to work. That was a fun experience, but I made it there safely and nothing bad happened. Sneaky sitting in the car. I don't like that. Oh, look how bright that is.
Instead of eating in the car, we're eating at Dill's backyard. It's 9 p.m., so this is going to be a little low light test for the Sony RX 100 Mark III. So let's see what we got. I got 10-piece chicken McNugget, a Big Mac, and Quinn got a Big Mac.
We have a puppy. Are you kidding me? You can't not let him outside. Literally, like, now she'll be like, are you kidding me? We have a dog, we have a puppy, like, literally, and that's, like, basic. And then I'm like, Mom, like, why you, what, like, I just want him inside. She's like, that's messed up, Dylan. I'm like,
well, he's gonna pee on us.
No, he's a good guy.
Good guys still pee.
Alright guys, so basically, I'm driving home from Dill's right now, and reflecting back on the day, thinking about it, this is probably going to be one of my longest vlogs yet. I would not be surprised if it's over an hour.
I just got home, and if you recall, because I definitely recall, me at Sam's Club saying, I know I definitely forgot something. Like, there's just something I don't have. I forgot something. And you know what it is? It's mayonnaise. Bunch of overpriced $5.49 mayonnaise action. Now I got to go get gas.
Let's look at my last meal of the day. We have a chicken soup with extra chicken, a good salad, fruits, and a watermelon. And that's basically gonna cap off my calories for the day. So now I'm gonna eat that and go upstairs, shower, and before I shower, I'm gonna weigh myself to see the difference in my morning weight and night weight. And then I'm gonna lay in bed with my laptop, edit as much of this as I can, pass out, wake up, and do stuff. So yeah, time to eat this.